intellect and its noble nature. The noble nature of knowledge has been revealed through intellect. Intellect is the source and fountainhead of knowledge and its foundation. Knowledge is like the fruit of a tree, and it flows from the intellect, and like the light of the sun or like the vision of the eye. Why should it not be honored when the cause of fortune in this world and the next? What is there to distinguish between beasts and men except for intellect? When the ferocious beast, which has got more strength than a man, fears a man at seeing him, as it knows that he may put a snare on account of his intellect. For this reason, the Prophet said, just as the ranks of the Prophet upon his followers, so is the rank of an old man over his people. This is not for wealth, or his long body, or his great strength, but his experiences that have grown out of intellect. For this reason, you will find ignorant near quadrupeds, and they were about to kill the Prophet. When they saw this noble countenance, they feared him, and they shone on their face the brilliance of prophethood, although it was latent in his soul in the same manner as intellect. My object is to show the honor of intellect from the Quran and the Hadith. Intellect has been termed as Noor or light in the following verse, quote, God is the light of the heavens and the earth. His light is like a niche, etc. 24:35. He named benefiting learning arising therefrom as spirit revelations of life. God said, thus I have revealed to you spirit by my command. 42:5. God said, have I not given life to one dead, and have I not created light for them with the help of which he can mix with the people? 6:122. Whenever God mentioned about light and darkness, he meant knowledge and ignorance. God said, he will take them from darkness into light. 5:18. The Prophet said, O people, acquire knowledge from your Lord and advise one another with intellect. Know that you have been enjoined and what you have been prohibited. Join and know that intellect will give you rank to over your learning. Know that intelligent man is he who obeys God, although his face is ugly, his body is small, his rank is low, and he may look shabby. An ignorant man is one who deceives God, although his appearance is beautiful, his body is long, his conduct is good, and his speech is fluent. He who disobeys God is no more intelligent than an ape or a pig. Don't mix with them, those who have received honor for love of this world, as they are doomed. The Prophet said, the first thing God created is intellect. He said to intellect, come near, and it came near. Then he said to it, go back, and it went back. The God said, by my honor and glory, I have created nothing in my sight more honorable than you. Through you I take, and through you I give. Through you I give reward, and through you I will punish. Once a party of men were praising a man before the Prophet and praised him excessively. The Prophet said, how is his intellect? They said, we shall inform you after seeking his diligence in prayer and other good deeds. Why do you ask us about his intellect? The Prophet said, the ignorance of an ignorant man is more harmful than the transgressions of a sinner. On the day of resurrection, a man will be raised to the rank of nearness to God in proportion to his intellect. The Prophet said, nobody earns a better thing than intellect. It shows him path towards guidance and saves him from destruction. The intellect of a man does not become perfect and his religion firm till his faith does not become perfect. The Prophet said, a man acquires the rank of praying all night and fasting all day through good conduct. The good conduct of a man does not become perfect till his intellect is not complete. And when his intellect becomes perfect, he obeys God and disobeys the enemies of the devil. The Prophet said, everything has the root, and the root of a believer is intellect, and his divine service will be in proportion to his intellect. Have you not heard the words of the sinner in hell? Had we heard and understood, we would not have been the inmates of hell. Hazrat Umar said, asked Tamim Dari, what is the supreme authority amongst you? He said, intellect. He said, have you spoken the truth? I had asked the Prophet as I had asked you, and he replied as you have replied. And the Prophet said, I asked Jibreel, what is the main thing? Jibreel said, intellect. Hazrat Bara bin Azib said, I asked many things of the Prophet. He said, O people, for everything there is a mainstay, and the mainstay of man is intellect. He who amongst you learns a thing by proof and argument is the best in intellect amongst you. Hazrat Abu Huraira said, when the Prophet returned from Uhud, he heard him saying, so and so is such and such. The Prophet then said, you have got no knowledge about these people. They asked, O Prophet of God, how? He said, each man has got a rank according to intellect God has given him. Their victory and their hope were in proportion to their intellect, so they reached to different ranks. On the day of resurrection, they will get those ranks according to their intentions and their intellect. The Prophet had also said, angels have been earnest and diligent in their obedience to God through their intellect, while the believers among the children of Adam have endowed to have that effect in proportion to their intellect. He who is more earnest in obedience to God's commandments is greater in intellect. Hazrat Aisha asked, O Prophet of God, for what thing do people in the world get excellence over one another? He said, for intellect. I asked, in the next world? He said, for intellect. I asked him, will they not get their reward in proportion to their actions? The Prophet said, O Aisha, do they act except in proportion to their intellect? Their actions will be in proportion to their intellect, and they will get reward in proportion to their actions. The Prophet said, everything has got a weapon, and the weapon of a believer is his intellect. Everything has got a mainstay, and the mainstay of a man is his intellect. Everything has got a support, and the support of religion is intellect. Every people have got a goal, and the goal of this people is intellect. Every people have got a missionary, and the missionary of the worshippers is intellect. Every merchant has got merchandise, and the merchandise of the diligent is intellect. Every amity has got a permanent house, and the basis of the house of Siddiqs is intellect. Everything has got a basis, and the basis of the next world is intellect. Every man has got an offspring to whom he is credited and mentioned, and the offspring of the Siddiq to which they are ascribed and mentioned is intellect. Each journey has a tent for shelter, and the tent of shelter of a believer is his intellect. The Prophet said, he who is greatest in intellect amongst you is the most dearful to God, and the greatest observant of what has been ordered and prohibited, even though he does not do much optional worship amongst you. The Prophet said, the believer, he who is most loved by God, is he whose sole goal is to obey the commandments of God, to admonish his servants, to complete his intellect, and to admonish himself. He who, according to that, for a few days of his life gets success and salvation. Truth about intellect and its division. Intellect is a word which has got four meanings. The first meaning, it is an attribute for which man can be distinguished from animals. It shows the path to theoretical learnings on the mastering the abstract disciples and the disciplines. Haris bin Asad said, in defining intellect, that is the most natural attribute by which theoretical sciences are grasped and understood, it is like a light which falls in the heart and helps it to understand things. He who denies this meaning and limits intellect to understand only the necessary sciences is wrong, as he who is indifferent to the sciences and he who is asleep are both classed by him in the same rank. They have got this instinct, though they are not learned. Such just a life in them helps them to move their bodies at sweet will, so also intellect is so much intermingled with some men that it helps them towards the acquisition of learnings and theoretical knowledge. Had it been possible that the natural intellect, sensations, and the power of understanding of a man and a donkey are equal with no difference, then it would have been possible for a donkey and a lifeless thing are equal regarding life with no difference. Just as, according to natural law, a donkey has been helped with life, so according to natural law, a man and a beast have been differentiated in the matter of theoretical learnings by intellect. Intellect is like a mirror which can be differentiated from other things having bodies by their special attribute according to form and color. This special attribute is polisher. The forehead can be differentiated from the eye as it has not been given the special quality of sight as in the case of the eye. As there is a connection of the eye with the sight, so also there is a connection of this natural quality of intellect with learning. Just there is a connection of sun rays with sight, so there is a connection of Sharia with the intellect with the view to express and spread learning. The second meaning. According to this meaning, intellect is wisdom which appears even in childhood as a body knows by instinct that two is greater than one and that an individual cannot remain in two different places at the same time. And that a lawful thing is not the same as an unlawful thing. Number three, the third meaning. Intellect means according to this knowledge acquired through experience. Thus he who laughs by experience and is schooled by time is called a man of intellect, and he who lacks these qualifications is called an ignorant. Fourth meaning. When the natural power of a man reaches such a point by which he can know the result of actions and for which the present pleasure of sexual passion is controlled, it is said that he has got intellect. Such a man is called an intelligent man. Such a man acts not by the dictates of passion but by the ultimate result of an action. The first meaning of intellect is its base and fountainhead. The second meaning is its branch near the first meaning, and the third meaning is the branch of the first and the second meanings. The fourth meaning is the ultimate result of intellect and the distant goal of intellect. The first two arise as natural causes and the later two are acquired through knowledge and experience. Hazrat Ali said, knowledge is of two kinds, natural and acquired. Acquired knowledge is useless without natural, just as the light of the sun rendered useless when the light of the eyes is closed. The first meaning is understood from the following hadith. The Prophet said, God has not created anything more honorable than intellect. The fourth meaning is understood from the following hadith. When a man comes close to the doors of religion and good deeds, he comes close to intellect. The Prophet said to Abu Darda, increase intellect, then your nearness to God will increase. Abu Darda said, may my parents be sacrificed to you. How will it be in my case? The Prophet said, avoid illegal things prohibited by God. Fulfill the obligatory duties ordered by God. You will then become a man of intellect. Do good deeds. Your honor and fame will increase in this world. And you will get and gain for that proximity to your Lord and honor in the next world. Hazrat Abu Huraira and other went to the Prophet and said, O Prophet of God, who is the most learned of men? He said, the wise. They asked, who is the best worshipper amongst men? He said, the wise. They asked him, who is the most excellent of men? He said, the wise. They asked him, is it not he, the wise man, who is the best in conduct, whose eloquence is well known, whose hand is full of charity, and whose rank is exalted? The Prophet said, these are the treasures of the life of the world, but the hereafter is for the people who fear God. The wise man is fearing God, though he is abject and despised in this world. The Prophet said, the wise man is he who believes in God, believes in his prophets, as true and obeys God's commandments. It appears from this that intellect is the name of natural instinct. It is, however, applied to knowledge as a thing is known by its fruits. A learned man is one who fears God, as fear of God is the fruit of learning. Thus, the word intellect, if applied to any fruit, becomes like a natural attribute. Knowledge does not come from the outside. It lies under intellect as a natural course. It is like water hidden in the earth. If a well is dug, the water comes out and no new thing is poured over it. Similarly, there is oil latent in almond seeds and in roses. To this effect, God says, when your Lord took out the progeny from the children of Adam from their backs and then took witness, am I not your Lord? They all said yes. 7:171 of the Quran. This means confession of their souls, not verbal promise by their tongue. God says about this matter, if you ask them who created you, they will answer God. 43:87. In other words, their souls will bear witness about it. God says, the natural religion of God upon which he created men, 30:29. In other words, the natural religion of every man is upon a thing that he should have faith in one God and know the natural attribute of each thing. In other words, this attribute is latent in him, so iman and faith is hidden in the heart of every man. Viewed from this angle, men are of two kinds. To one kind of men, iman and the faith was presented, but they forgot it and they were unbelievers. And to another kind of men who cultivated their souls and they remembered it, these people are like those who forgot a thing after remembering it, and afterwards it was reminded to them. God says, for this, so that they may remember you, 14 surah of the Quran, that those with understanding may remember, 38:28. Remember the gifts of God upon you and your covenant with him, Quran 5:10. I have made the Quran easy for remembrance. Is there anyone who will remember it? 54:17. Soul is like a horseman and the body is like a horse. The blindness of the horseman is more serious and harmful than that of the horse. The power of intellect, internal insight, is more than that of external sight. Thus God said, his soul fulfilled not what he saw, 53:18. And thus I showed Ibrahim the kingdom of the heavens and the earth, 6:75. The opposite of inner sight and insight is blindness. God says, it is not the eyes that are blind, but the souls which are in their breasts, 22:45. God says, he who is blind in the world will also be blind in the hereafter. These secrets were revealed to the Prophet, some through insight and some through sight, and both were called sight. He shows insight is not ripe, acquired nothing but husk of religion. These attributes are called intellect. Intellectual disparity of men. As the land are of several kinds, so there is disparity of intellect in different individuals by instinct. This disparity of intellect is in different individuals is also understood from tradition. Abdullah bin Salam narrated that the Prophet at the end of a long sermon described the throne and stated that angels asked God, O God, have you created anything greater than the throne? He said, yes, intellect. They asked, how great is it? He said, alas, your intellect cannot grasp it. Can you count the number of sands? They said, no. God said, I have created intellect in different minds as numerous as sands. Some men have been given one grain, some two, some three, some four, and some over 1/5, some 1/6, and some more. This disparity of intellect is found in all its meanings as described above, except the second, namely axiomatic knowledge, such as a thing that two is greater than one, that an object cannot remain in two places at the same time, and that thing cannot be both eternal and originated. Intellect, with reference to three other meanings, is subject to disparity. With regards to the fourth meaning of intellect, namely controlling power, disparity of men is clear and evident. For instance, the power to control appetite and sexual passion is different in different people, even if it is different in the same individual at different stages of life. A wise man will be able to overcome appetite more easily than an ignorant and an illiterate man. A young man may fail to overcome sexual appetite, but when he grows old, he is able to do it. The disparity is also due to differences in knowledge of a subject. Thus, a man having special knowledge of medicine may refrain from other harmful foods, while a layman fails to do so simply because he lacks medical knowledge. Similarly, a learned man is more competent to give up sin than an ignorant man. Jazakallah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.